We'll be right back. I think maybe I'll talk a little bit about the slap technique. We didn't go too in depth with it. Basically, I'm using my thumb the same way I use a pick. So there's a down and an up stroke, you know? You begin to add other fingers. You can do 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. So. You can do 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. Which is fun. Well, there's more approaches than just the percussive. You can do more melodic things in the upper register. Kind of using hammer-ons as well as the thumping. So if I did a triad, stuff like that. So it's pretty fun. But what I started to do is use my pick the same way I was using my thumb. So I started making phrases that were combination of hammer-ons and picking. So if I wanted to do a group of three, I would have 1, 2, 3. So yeah. So there's a song I'm going to play now called Cascade that is actually started off as an exercise doing groups of 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So I turned this exercise into a piece of music, so I'll play that for you. We'll be right back. know most of you were here for the masterclass, but I don't know if there's any more questions I can answer. So,
what string gauge do you use?
String gauge 9 to 72 for the lowest, yeah. So my guitar, the neck is longer than a normal guitar. This is baritone scale, 27 inches. So 9 gauge strings feel like 10 almost, because the longer is scale length.
We'll be right back.
Maybe we'll talk about tapping a little bit. I have some approaches to tapping that aren't the, you know, traditional sort of lead guitar. It's more about doing things that maybe sound closer to a piano or something like that. A good trick is to take a chord. Then you can use multiple fingers on your right hand. So when I tap, I pull off and those notes ring against the chord that I'm holding. You can... It's a nice little effect. It sounds very melodic, you know? And the song I just played, I was using an approach to tapping that I do often. I'll take a set of numbers, like five. My left hand will play three notes. And then my right hand does four and five. So we have a single chord here. And what I do is these three notes remain the same, but I move my right hand to create new chords against this hand. So you have... It's a cool way to produce a chord progression without actually strumming it. And I don't know if it sounds like tapping as much as it sounds like almost like arpeggiated something on like a keyboard. So that's pretty fun. I'll take another question if anyone has any. You have one? Almost standard, but this string is tuned to E. So I have... three E strings. The whole guitar, I can treat almost like standard. Like if I did a... So it allows me to play all eight strings in one position. Which is nice. Standard tuning. Anyone else have a question?
Why eight strings?
Who said that? Yeah. It's simply because of the extended range. I mean, like, you know, I really like, you know, these sounds. And then you can do things like, you know, it's almost like bringing a bass into your guitar. And then even with things like, tapping. It's just nice to have so many strings. Hopefully my music is illustrating the point of having an extended range guitar. I mean, especially when you get into, you know, emulating bass. That's pretty fun to do, you know? Thanks.
Man, you could just fire a bass player in your band, right?
We don't have a bass player.
Really, you don't? Okay.
But it's circumstantial because we have like MIDI bass.
Like a lot of
Yeah.
Started like playing bass.
Because of me.
Just a quit this like eighth string, okay?
Stop it. You're here. Thank you. You can't replace the bass guitar. We still have in our recordings. We have like we'll either use a synth, or we'll track some bass guitar. Just we don't have a member of the band who's playing bass, so we save a little bit of money that way too. Cool. Any other questions?
Do you consider moving to a 9-string or at least have you tried this?
I tried a 9-string. I don't really think it's for me. The way I tune my guitar, it's pretty self-contained. Another string would kind of, I don't know, change the way I view my fretboard. And I still think I'm exploring 8 strings. An extra string doesn't seem necessary just yet. What? You have a question?
What amps you used
before Cracow? Oh. I used some Engel. Do you know Engel? Mesa Boogie. Yeah, I don't know. And PV.
Why you decide to use Cracow?
Because it's the perfect machine. It does everything. You know? So much control. Like, I have compression. I have parametric EQ, I have all the effects I need, I have cab simulations, mic simulations. I think it sounds pretty good. What you're hearing is straight into the PA, so it allows you to sound like you have a full amp setup, even though you're just playing direct. So for recording, it's amazing too. Have you tried it? I recommend it. Okay, may I do another song? Okay. Thank you. Lately I've been listening to a piano player from Armenia named Tigran Hamasyan. He makes really interesting music. And I listen to a lot of jazz, like Adam Rogers, Kurt Rosenwinkel. And then I listen to rap, actually, because I like it. And electronic music is really cool because the sounds and the textures are so diverse. It just doesn't sound like a guitar. It's as if the world of sound is available to them, and I like hearing that. So I don't know, electronic music is very stimulating to me. I listen to a lot of that, so yeah, that's about it. You're welcome. What I wanted to achieve when I started Animals as Leaders was my perfect band, like the music that I wish someone else was making. So it's a combination of electronic music, jazz, heavy metal, shred guitar, progressive metal. I just took all my favorite music and put it into one project. And I wanted to be somebody's favorite band or someone's favorite guitar player, actually. So my dreams have come true, actually, because I have a signature guitar now and I get to travel the world playing my music. So I achieved what I wanted from the band. It's pretty awesome. Yeah. Any other questions? I have a lot. I like Alan Holdsworth, Frederick Dordendahl, Adam Rogers, Kurt Rosenwinkel, Jimmy Herring, Guthrie Govan.
Your band inspires Meshuggah?
We are very inspired by Meshuggah. They kind of started the whole 8-string thing. Their rhythm, their rhythmic vocabulary is very unique, and we kind of just stole it from them. Yeah. Anyone else?
Okay, I have another question. How do you write your leading part? I mean, do you record your back tracks, rhythm guitars, and then just improvise and hear what is sounding good? Or
yeah. Yeah, but there are theoretical approaches that I use. So let me see. Like a minor chord, I oftentimes use a major arpeggio, the relative major. So I'm actually using major scale, but against the minor it has a very nice sound. And then obviously I'll do things like the intervallic playing. And I do a lot of arpeggios, so So that's kind of like my approach, you know. With the arpeggios I was just doing, they were pentatonic based. So you're going to have a lot of... But I like, you know... My approach is kind of improvisation until I find phrases that I really like, and then I try to compose by combining the improvisation into a statement. Because I'm not very good at improvisation. I just think it's better for me to write a guitar solo, a memorable guitar solo if I can, and leave it like that. And then, but yeah, that's kind of some of my approach. Theoretically, like I said, the relative major of a minor chord, it sounds really good. Against the minor chord, you know? So if you're in B Dorian, you can go to D major. Does that make sense? Yeah, well, this approach is called superimpositions. It's imposing one scale over a chord where maybe it doesn't belong. Like, for instance, say if I take a major 7 chord. Obviously, I can play B major. But a cool thing to do is to go down a half step, yeah? Now play minor pentatonic. You get a Lydian sound. So now I'm using like blues phrasing against the major chord, and the sound is like a Lydian sound. So it's like a cool little trick, you know? Scott Henderson has a video full of the whole video is superimpositions. So he tells you a chord and he says, go to the minor third and play a major pentatonic, or go to the fifth and play a minor pentatonic, or, you know what I'm saying? So it's like formulas. But, you know, if you can remember 2 or 3, it can be very useful in your soloing, because then you have this sound that is not obvious.
All right, thank you.
You're welcome. All right. I think I have time for one more song. It's a crazy song. But I want to thank you guys for coming to the clinic. I hope you enjoyed yourself and learned something. We'll be right back. Cinquia.
All right.
No dobra. Chyba było dobrze. Powiem tak, było ciężko ściągnąć tu Tosina, nie ze względu na niego, bo on bardzo chciał, ale różne były przeciwności losu, jednak udało nam się go tutaj ściągnąć. I osobiście jestem z tego bardzo dumny i cieszę się, że tutaj jesteście z nami. Natomiast chyba pora na konkurs. No, niektórzy z was, bo chyba nie wszyscy, napisali hasło konkursowe i wysłali je tam, gdzie trzeba i zrobili dokładnie to, co trzeba. Tak więc ja idę po gitarę, a wy... Poczekajcie. Dobra, jest pudełeczko. Poproszę listę z hasłami i to zwycięskie hasło. Tosin, would you like to give a guitar to the winner?
Sure.
Okay.
Should I open it?
Yeah, let's open it.
Could you please read the name of the winner? Fifth.
Okay.
Paulina Rusinska.
Bravo.
Congratulations.
Thank you very much.
Very nice guitar. The phrase?
Yeah.
I don't know.
Dobra, tu jest tak. Hasło wybierał dyrektor Ibaneza polskiego. To jest potwierdzone info. Dostałem od niego telefon przed konkursem. I hasło, które Paulina wymyśliła, brzmi: Ibanez, nastroi cię do grania. Paulina, masz coś do powiedzenia?
I'm very happy that I won that wonderful guitar. And I would like to say that I'm great fan of Animals as Leaders. My boyfriend recommended Animals as Leaders to me when we started to meeting, and I like it from the first note, cool, from the first hearing. So awesome. Very nice music. Thank you.
Thank you.